Altamira Gold's Mike Bennett is here now here at Mines and Money 2021, and you've had some news hot off the press today for us, Mike, haven't you? So the Santa Helena project, tell us all about it.
Well, thanks very much, Katie. Yeah, we are pleased to announce to the public that we managed to get hold of a drill rig, which is difficult right now in Brazil. Over the last 2 months, we've been fast-tracking our exploration there in Santa Helena. We cleaned out an old mining pit, an artisanal mining pit, and discovered 100 meters of stockwork. And the stockwork is this crisscrossing of veins in the wall of the pit there. It looks very, very similar in its geometry to the stockwork seen at the Jaca deposit in 60 kilometers to the northeast of our Santa Helena project, which is the porphyry copper discovered by Anglo-American in 2017. And so what we did was we contracted our consultant, a very experienced geologist from Chile. He looked at the data, he looked at the photos of the stockwork, and he has decided it looks very, very similar to porphyry style of stockworking. And then we also were lucky enough to have some old data, some old geophysical data from the property area. We put that all together, and lo and behold, right below us, we have an IP chargeability high at a depth of about 200 meters, and a coincident geophysical resistivity high. So we've decided to go in there and leap in with all hands to the pump. We will be drilling three holes into this project in the next 2 or 3 weeks. And we'll obviously be very, very keen to see the fresh core that's coming out of the ground.
Good stuff. Well, we wish you the best of luck with that. Maybe tell us more about the origin, because I understand 6 years ago it was all about gold for you, and now you're focusing on copper?
Yeah, we're looking at copper for a reason. If you look at these projects, they're very, very large project areas. And so you've got gold spread over, for example, in Apiacaz, over 60 kilometers of east-west strike length. So something somewhere down there is causing all this gold to come to surface. And so what we're looking at now, we're looking at the idea that there is a buried source, maybe a porphyry, it may be some sort of intrusive activity, but something is causing this. In Apiacaz, we're seeing a lot of copper as well. And so where we're seeing gold and copper together in our surface soil samples, we're trying to put together a 3D idea. We'll trench, and we will also drill these new areas.
Okay.
So Santa Helena has two targets. It has the possible porphyry source or buried intrusive source of both gold and base metals. And it has some very, very high grade gold in quartz veins. So visible gold in the quartz. The local miners were attracted to the area originally for that, and we will certainly be targeting that in our drill program this in the next couple of months as well.
Excellent. So three projects in total, keeps you busy?
Very, very busy. We've got an increasingly large team now of five geologists in the field. We'll probably have a third project in 2022, which is our Cachoeira project, up and running as well in terms of the exploration. We'll be doing both trenching and drilling in that project. And of course, as soon as we get the environmental license, we will put together our project for the early stage mining in Cachoeira as well in 2022. So interesting times.
Mike, you recently moved to Brazil yourself. How do you find the mining culture there and the opportunities and just working in the country?
I think the opportunities are fantastic, Katie. I think, you know, if you look at the area, look at Mato Grosso, the north of Mato Grosso in general. 45 years ago, the whole area was jungle. And what has happened in those 45 years is, first of all, the local miners moved in. Why was I attracted as a geologist to the north of Mato Grosso is because the area produced 10 million ounces of gold, and they just scratched the surface to produce that. So that, to me as a geologist, said, look, there's got to be a deeper source and a primary source to this surface gold they've taken out. And then we were first comers to the show here, to the party. We were able to pick up a very large land position as a junior. And I must say that you could not do that as a junior today. You know, the rules have changed now. You have to bid for the things in terms of money, and the majors obviously have got bigger pockets than ourselves. So we were very lucky. We've got some extremely interesting areas. Mm-hmm. And great, we're drilling. You know, that's the most important thing.
That's all you want. Well, enjoy your visit back to the capital. Thank you so much indeed. That's Mike Bennett there from Altamira Gold here on Proactive London.